Now, I'd like to quickly explain the difference between what's called on-site and off-site SEO factors. This is also known as on-page or off-page. Now, firstly, on-site SEO. That basically relates to anything you do within your actual website. So here are some examples. It's not an exclusive list, but you know, these are some of the important ones. There's things like your domain name. Ideally, you should have your keyword phrase within your domain name. So my training website for SEO is called www.4seotraining.com.au. So it has the domain name with the keywords embedded within it. Now, probably the most important on-site SEO factor of all is the title, the HTML title. This can make the difference between good SEO and basically not being found. So even if you get this right and you totally mess up everything else, you've still got a shot of being on the first page. That's how important the title is. So there is a video on these various bits and pieces. As I say, the most important one of all is the HTML title. Probably next in importance would be things like alt tags and headings and anchor text. Those are probably the three most important ones after the title. So alt tags, again, there's a video on that. An alt tag is basically a tag, a hidden bit of information behind the pictures you upload to your website. So Google can understand the text within your page, but it doesn't really understand what the pictures are about. So the idea of the alt text is it basically tells Google, you know, gives Google some information about the pictures. Headings, you can have headings 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to 3 to 6 if you want to. But from an SEO point of view, the important headings are the H1s and the H2s, the primary heading and the secondary headers. So again, you want to try and get your keywords within the headings on the page. Again, there's a video on that. Next, we come to anchor text. Anchor text is purely the text within a clickable link, within a clickable text link. Quality content. This is very, very important. It's no point doing the SEO if you haven't got a good website to start off with. So spend a lot of time producing good quality content that people would actually want to read. The loading speed of each page is important, especially on mobiles. So that's something you need to pay attention to. The next sort of on-site factor would be things like, have you got an XML sitemap and an HTML sitemap? Again, if you've got no idea what those are, check out my other videos. They're just ways of helping Google to find its way around your site. The way you set up the internal linking structure within your website, again, that's an important SEO factor. And again, there is, like always, there's a right way and a wrong way of doing this. Broken links. Google's totally unimpressed if it finds broken links on your website. You might get away with one or two, but certainly you want to check your website on a regular basis just to make sure you haven't got any broken links between your pages, or indeed a broken link from your website to somebody else's website. The hosting location, that can affect your SEO. If you're interested in local business within a particular country or a particular part of a country maybe, then try and get local hosting. So for instance, I'm in a city called Perth in Western Australia, and all my hosting is done within Australia. Duplicate content, that's another issue you need to think about. Some of these factors are plus factors, some are negative factors. Duplicate content is certainly a negative factor that you need to be careful of. So what you do not want to do ever is basically cut and paste information from one page to another page within your website. If you want to create similar information, create it from scratch. Don't cut and paste it. And then finally, of course, you need your website these days to be mobile friendly. So this is not a complete list, but it kind of gives you an idea of some of the what's called the on-site SEO factors, and you need to get all of these right. So what's off-site SEO? Well, primarily it's links, ideally links from other websites, but also links from your own social media. So if you've got things like a YouTube channel, Facebook, you know, Google+, LinkedIn, Twitter, Pinterest, etc., you want these all set up with links back to your site. And ideally you want links from other people's blogs and other people's Facebook pages and all the rest of it. So the more links you get, the better. But there is a proviso there that really these days what you want are links from sites that are relevant to what you do. So for instance, I'm primarily interested in SEO training, so having a link from, say, a widget manufacturer doesn't really help me. You know, I would benefit from fewer high quality relevant links rather than lots and lots of low quality links. Incidentally, once people become aware of the fact that links are important from an SEO point of view, they're kind of tempted to go and buy links. You must never ever do that, because Google is extremely good at finding out what are called link farms. And if you sign up to a company that basically provides you with a whole bunch of links for a small amount of money, then that is a very good way of getting yourself banned from Google these days, because that specifically breaks the Google guidelines. If you haven't already seen it, search using the phrase Google Webmaster Guidelines, and that will take you to a page on Google's website. And on there, it'll basically give you some tips of things to do and things not to do. And one of the things you must not do is break the guidelines. And the best way of breaking the guidelines would be to buy links. And as I said, that could get you banned. So, you know, do beware. Link building is something that should occur naturally. Certainly, if you listen to Google, Google take the point of view that if you've got really high quality content, then people will start naturally linking to you. Obviously, it depends what your website's about. I have a number of businesses. One of my businesses is I sell computer training materials to basically organizations or companies that deliver computer training, you know, things like Microsoft Word and what have you. And on that website, I make freely available samples of the complete courses. So not surprisingly, I've got literally thousands and thousands of links. I didn't ask for one of them. Because the quality of the content is so good and it's freely available as a download, as a sample, then an awful lot of people, an awful lot of good websites have linked to that website. So that sort of emphasizes the fact that if you produce good quality content, people will link to you. One of the tricks you can do to try and get people linking to you instantly is to produce tips and trick sheets, or, you know, the 101 sheets or something like that. You know, the, in my case, tips and tricks for, say, SEO or SEO 101. And just a simple page with maybe a download on it will actually attract an awful lot of links from other people. Another great way that people kind of miss out on in a lot of cases is YouTube, because YouTube is the second most widely used search engine after Google itself, and Google own YouTube. So if you can establish your own YouTube channel and have original content on it, you'll find you get an awful lot of traffic through to your website. But those are the sort of things you need to consider when you're talking about off-site SEO factors.